think the opposite side is doing today is taking advantages. Just because these vulnerable individuals are not in the right state of mind, they only want money, preaching and the coercion happening here won't make things better. So I'll interview all my rebuttals in the comparison that I'll do later. So today, religious organizations go do charity, go perform charity, not because they're genuine, right? Because because they want to gain more followers and because they know that that it is easy for these people to be manipulated because these people are poor and they only want money. And we need that these religious organizations want to do charity because they want to gain more followers, not because of their genuinity, not because like they're just not in class. So the standard of today's debate is that the side who is going to win today's debate is the side which protects the most vulnerable individuals, these poor people, in making such important life decisions like religion. So now I'm going to talk about, I'm going to make a comparison. So the opening batch talked about how religion gives hope slash happiness, how religion gives happiness. So if we can prove to you that the happiness on the dark side is fake or even temporary, and it's just because they want more charity, we take today this issue. Because happiness happening to these people is because they are getting more food. They can it's because they are getting these funds, not because they are actually happy to be in the region, because they comply to this region because they are getting help. So next, they also talked about the purpose of a religion, a religious organization is solely to gain followers, and this religious organization should just put in more money to gain more followers. But we see that religious organizations should Underworld is not about that. They should, you know, spend more money on like religious activities which can increase the quality of the religion and not increase the followers that are not even quality yet. And because when they give charity, they have to constantly give charity to ensure that these people will constantly believe in that and also the religion. So next, that they say that under their side, these people still have a choice to accept or not accept that religion. But if I can prove to you that you are stripping away the choices of these people, that these people will still comply and still agree at the end of the day, we take to this issue. Because under your side, when you are coercing them, that these people will somehow feel bad and say you are guilt-tripping them and forcing them to join the religion. When you give the charity, you will say that coercion will happen. So next, CEOs. They say that by spreading ideologies, they're just spreading ideologies. Like charity is a platform to spread ideologies. But we say that ideologies won't even reach them because they'll just comply, they'll just agree. They're being manipulated. They're being manipulated because they're just agreeing because they want the funds. Plus, no engagement about how these people are going about how my speaker talked about how being manipulated and guilt-tripping. My speaker before me talked about how the long-term effects of this charity preaching, when people only follow religion for the sake of donation, where how minorities will equate this will equate happiness with the charity and not the religion, and how financially unstable religious organizations will have to be at the end of the day. So no responses from the opposite side. But before that, yes.
You say that they join the religion because of money. It's not true, because if they're not joining the religion, they still get the charity money.
But of course that these religious organizations will constantly give their charity money when they follow this religion. If they don't follow, then this religious organization will stop. So next, how they talked about it being a bonus and stuff like that. But we believe that this bonus won't last long. If you can't supply charity and supply enough charity, these people will lose faith, like my members said, and it will just be lose more followers and everything. So this is why preaching is a form of coercion and guilt-trip, because these religious organizations know that these people are not in the right state of mind, so it's easy for them to give the teaching and for them to accept. So religion is one of the most important life decisions that all individuals has the right to choose. But looking at the state of mind of these individuals, we believe that proselytizing during Christianity is not suitable in this case. So second, about guilt tripping and how the government side wants to go and preach, they'll say that if you don't join our religion, people who are not Islam will spend their akhirah in neraka or stuff like that. So we believe that this manipulation is wrong, because not just these people will just enter this religion because they want to have fun. It's not because and it's just you're guilt tripping them at the end of the day. So my speaker before me has told you about the long term harm of preaching towards these individuals and also towards this religious organization, because now they will eventually lose faith in these religions. These religious organizations, when these religious organizations won't give them more funds, and they're willing to do anything to accept they'll do anything and conditions to accept the funds. And humanitarian aids and donations are temporary and unstable, just like my members said. So if you want a world where if you want a world that's best for vulnerable individuals, go with closing the window. Thank you.